Don't know where, don't know when, but I know we'll meet again some sunny day. Keep smiling through, just like you always do, till the blue skies drive the dark cloud.
The effect of the war, now we lost all the specialist teachers in the holiday period of 1940. So we went on holiday with the full staff and came back, and we lost the art master, two science masters, two woodwork masters, one of the English masters has gone.
Men have came back?
Well, they were serving in the war, and I left, of course, in 43, so I don't know what happened. I never heard that anything nasty had befallen them, but it may well have done.
Well, it was 940 pupils when I was here, so it's now 2,000. There's a lot more buildings than there ever were before. It seems more cramped than it was. I think there was lots of space about, but there, at least there's a new staff room, because the old staff room used to be a shed where that blue building is.
I've seen firsthand what the staff room used to be.
It was really a playroom, it wasn't really a staff room.
We had some really good fun in the prefect's room, and it was the swinging 60s, and the parties afterwards were really good things. AJ Hales was AJ was a top headmaster, and he transformed the school. He turned it into, it was really quite a, oh, you're going to Chatsworth Road, oh, bad luck. But he turned it into, we got people wearing uniforms, he introduced O-levels, he introduced A-levels, which it wasn't even thought of when we first came here.
That's right.
And he really pushed it, created a grammar stream, and really raised the standards.
It turned it into a good school, it's made lots of good friends. Long-lasting as well, I mean, you know, it's what, 60 years.
I don't know where, and I don't know when, but I do know that we'll meet again some sunny day.
The size of the school, first of all, I think there were probably just over 1,000 pupils there when I came here. There are now 2,100. The amount of buildings that are in the school, furbished really well now, lots of good equipment in the school.
Oh, I just remember we were down the shelters and sort of singing songs and drawing doing artwork on the walls of the shelters. And of course this is such a huge school now to what we
were. Was it lots
more? Oh yes, and of course the field was huge.
And tell them I won't be long. They'll be happy to know that as you saw me go, I was singing the song.
Favorite memory? Oh, definitely the day trips to France. Definitely. Staff trips. Wonderful. We used to go
on the minibus.
That was it. Went in the minibus.
Lots of memories. I think the development of the tennis scholarship and seeing them go to Ten Downing Street, that was quite interesting. I've been involved in lots of trips, ski trips, water sports trips. I was very grateful that Mo Rubin managed to get me on the Borough Cruise, and they were obviously fantastic adventures to have.
We had a promise made for hands and then away, both under influence. We had divine said to know what to say. Mind is a razor blade to call for hands of above.
Cheam High School.
in your first day working there? Do you remember?
Even then I thought, what a massive place to be working, and the number of people here seemed huge, because I hadn't really experienced a school with that sort of size of students.
I was sitting over there. It was sixth form parents' evening. I was head of sixth form, and it was sixth form block that burnt down. And I remember the caretaker coming over and saying, "Dave, better come and move your car because the sixth form block's on fire." And I thought he was joking, but went over there, and of course it was. And as I was moving my car out of, because you could park around there at the time, so I was moving my car out, one of the windows exploded and flames came leaping out of the sixth form block window. Yeah, yeah. So I suppose that was a memory that that lasts.
Harrowing experience with ladders falling and trying to stop pigeons getting into the sports hall. The main hall got flooded and the floor came up. We managed to re-get it down, but it was a different life. But I also remember it when it was a youth club during the war. We used to use the girls' side, and their sports hall was the Cheam Youth Club. And I came there in 1944.
I was a temporary staff room, a bit like a hut. And I remember walking in there for the first time at lunchtime, and the contrast with what I was expecting was huge. It was incredibly noisy, crowded. Not only were people in there eating lunch, they seemed to be playing games of cricket and football as well. It was absolutely amazing. And that kind of set the scene for the next 6 years. Just brilliant chaos and lots of noise, lots of laughter. It was brilliant.
Thank you so much. To call for hands up above, to lean on, would it be good enough for me now? To call for hands up above.